Welcome to Seed to Life. Summer is in full swing in Texas. Temperatures are going above 100 degrees Fahrenheit. It is hard for me to go out and check on my plants after 8 a.m. in the morning without getting sunburns. But whenever I come back in after taking care of my plants, I can enjoy this very fragrant and cooling drink, Kush Sharbat. I'm not sure how many of you have heard about this ancient medicinal grass, Kush or couscous or vetiver or wala. It is a type of grass that has fragrant roots. Whenever I make this drink, it's not just refreshing, but the aroma spreads in the entire room. I used to buy this ready-made syrup from the market, but this time I decided to grow the grass so that I can get the fragrant grass in the most natural form without any chemicals or added sugars. The essential oils from Kush grass are widely used in the perfume industry for soap making and for making several beauty products. But many of you might not know that Kush grass is also a traditional medicine. For hundreds of years, probably thousands of years, the essential oils from this grass is used to treat various ailments. I have already mentioned earlier that Kush syrup has a very cooling effect on the body. It is also a stress reliever. It is commonly used in aromatherapy. Kush essential oils are known to have a calming effect on the nervous system and can act as a sedative and potentially used in the treatment of nervous system diseases such as epilepsy or hysteria. The intoxicating aroma is linked to its aphrodisiac effect. Kush grass extracts reduce the inflammation and promotes healing of wounds. They also diminish the scar. Other than these medicinal uses, Kush or vetiver grass has several other benefits that are very important. The refreshing scent of Kush makes it a natural air freshener. Leaves of Kush are used as a fodder or cattle food. The plant as a whole is used in various art projects and making of textile, grass drapes, curtains, garlands, baskets, and pupuris. The curtains made from Kush grass are still famous in India. They are also used in a traditional brick making. They are aromatic and cooling and can be produced with zero environmental waste. Coming on to the most vital benefit of Kush grass. These plants are now considered one of the best remedies for erosion control. Every year, tons of soil is washed off in the drains, rivers, and ultimately goes to sea. Kush grass roots are pretty sturdy and hold on to the soil, reducing this runoff of the soil and nutrients. Traditionally, Kush grass was used along the sides of the fields, on river banks, but now even more attention is given to its benefit as a natural method of erosion control. This grass is a drought-tolerant grass and pest-repellent. It is also water-resistant to some extent. Even the World Bank has taken a lot of interest in using vetiver grass for soil and water conservation. Isn't it amazing? Now we know a lot about this plant, and let's see how to grow this plant in your home garden. Let's begin. I have 4 Kush grass plants that are potted. I grew them from 4 slips that I purchased online. If you keep them potted, they are not going to grow to their maximum potential for sure. But still, they are growing pretty fast. There are 2 types of vetiver grass or Kush grass. One is domesticated, which is infertile, and the other one is wild variety that grows in wild and also produces seeds. This grass grows in varying climates and conditions. In fact, it is known to grow in bauxite containing soil, which is not good for most plants and kills them. They are resistant to grazing, fire or drought, even moisture. Last week, we suddenly got a very heavy rain, which is not unusual in Texas, a state where weather keeps on giving us surprises every day. Several inches of rain submerged the roots in water for a couple of days as I didn't go out and check on them. But this grass did not show any signs of distress due to excess moisture. The roots are pretty strong and dense. They can penetrate the soil to the depth of 3 meters. So if you decide to plant them directly in the ground, just choose your spot wisely because it is going to grow big, huge. If you decide to move the grass after planting, then you will have to put in a lot of efforts. The good thing is that the grass just grows in diameter locally instead of spreading like lawn grass. So overall, this grass is pretty resilient except in shade. So you can choose a nice sunny spot to grow it. This is just like grass. So a normal well-balanced potting mix is good for faster growth. I always prefer organic feeding like fertilizers, cow manure, compost. But this is a grass, you can add any other grass fertilizer. Remember, organic methods of growing always help in the long run. I believe it is also frost tolerant but definitely dies back in winter. That means as the temperature gets better in the spring, it should grow back. Before winter, you can just chop off the foliage up to 4 to 6 inches from the ground and then cover the grass up with some cardboard or mulch to protect the roots. You can see some of the roots are coming out from the pot. They were growing in the collected water, but instead of turning black, they are looking very clean and healthy. Now let's check out the roots. A big thanks for watching my videos. Please subscribe to my channel Seed to Life and share my videos. Video links are posted in the description. See you again. Bye.